Yeah, I'm Tanvi. I got placed at Gardner. So, do I get placed? The questions which I already have, which I thought I covered today, were what does the company do? What would I be working on? I have a few questions with me, which I thought I'll cover today. So, basically, what does the company do? What would the project basically be? When did I start my preparation, and what was the preparation basically? How was the test and interview process? And what are the materials? And do's and don'ts for interview and placement tests. Anything else that you want me to cover? Okay, so Gartner is the world's leading research and advisory company. It provides research and analytics solution for various other businesses and enterprises. So the profile which Gartner offers is Leaded Associate. So Leaded stands for Leadership and Excellence in Analytics, Data Science and Information Technology. So it's basically a rotational profile where you'll be working for a period of 3 to 9 months on different sectors like data science, advanced analytics, IT, and product management. So your projects will also differ in those aspects. Like for 3 to 7 months, 3 to 9 months, you'll be working in IT where or product management where you'll like probably build internal or user-facing apps, or you'll be working with some data to provide some research solutions. And yeah, that's it. Anything about the company? I'll move on to the preparation then. So the process for Gartner is a placement test, which had two sections. It had one aptitude and one technical section. Aptitude was a basic probab, statistics, and some English questions. So preparation for that would be the placement team will share some material, and other if you have like CAT preparation, the CAT material for aptitude. And for technical, what I refer to was HackerRank, HackerEarth. So those were the things which really helped me for the technical part. And another tip which I thought really helped me for not just Gartner, for almost all the placement tests was the really good company, like the day 1 to day 3 kind of companies come a bit later, and the day 5, 7, 8, 9 companies come, like they come much earlier for the placement tests. So what I did was I registered for all of them, so I had a lot of practice for writing the placement tests. So even if you're not aiming for the initial companies which come for the placement test, just register and try to practice those tests. And even like after the test, try to like, even if you couldn't do it during the test, try to solve the questions which were there in those tests. Because it'll help you in the companies which come later, like Goldman Sachs, Gartner, and everything. So how did the interviews go? The interviews for Gartner were, the people who came for Gartner were really friendly and like super chill. So I had 3 rounds of interview. The first one, so in my one tip which I think almost everyone will tell you is be very thorough with your resume. So my first round was, so I had a data science intern in my resume, so they asked me, so they saw that I have done quite a few things about data science. So they asked, okay, it seems like being a non-CS elec or data science person, you've done a lot in data science. So if someone wants to start working in data science field, how would you suggest? So I had done a bit of consult prep, so I made out a full structure about how do you start. Like you start with math, you start with coding, you start with application, hands-on practice. So like be very structured in whatever you're answering. Like think before you answer. And whatever you're thinking, make sure it's very clear, like communicated very well. And my second question was a very basic puzzle. I think most of you would have done that for internships. That one, there are two identical ropes which burn in 60 minutes. You're in a room with two ropes, and if you get out in 45 minutes, what do? So a very basic question. And I thought that that was it. That was the end of my first interview. I thought it's too small, so I started interviewing the interviewer. I showed interest in his work, which I think even they liked, because it showed that I am interested in the company. My second interview was also kind of based on my internship. I had used some k-means clustering and regression. So they asked me, okay, how do you, if not, why did you choose this method of regression and not something else? What if the features were more? What if the observation, the data set was more? What would you have done? And he gave me one problem to which I had to approach through different solutions. So if your basics are clear, you'll be able to you'll be able to give your interview properly. So I had this misconception, and I think a lot of other people do, that Gartner is only for CS elect people or the data science people. I don't think that's true. So I asked my seniors, I asked even during the interview, if I would need to know IT, I would need to know all the product development and web development and all those things. So they were pretty chill. They were like, if you want to learn, you will get the opportunity to learn once you are in the job. You don't really need to know all of those things, but be thorough in at least one of the three segments, which is analytics or data science or information technology. So either one of those. If they see that you have good foundation, they'll make sure that they'll help you build on it. So do's and don'ts during interview: be confident, be clear in communication, and just be thorough with your resume and be thorough with the basics of whatever is there in your resume. Why do I think that I got selected for Gartner compared to some of my peers? I don't think I knew more about data science or coding. It's just that I thought I communicated better and I showed more interest. So I think those were the key points. And what are the future opportunities, exit options for Gartner? So Gartner does not just the advanced analytics data science, it also has consulting, finance within the company. And it's an international company which has just one office in India, which is in Gurgaon. But it has lot of other, offices in US, UK, and lot of other places. So it has option for internal mobility. So that is one option, that you can choose to move within Gartner to different offices, or you can go for MS in data science related fields, or you can even go for MBA. So yeah, those are the future options or exit opportunities. Anything else that I missed out?
Do I just have any questions?
They asked about your performance in
Hackerly. They asked about my performance in Hackerly.
Like, why did you not participate, or if you participated, why not?
No. So the question was, did they check my performance in HackerRank or any other?
No, on that Gartner HackerList.
No, they did not ask for my. So the only selection criteria was the Gartner test, nothing else. Yeah. Was there a CGPA cutoff? I don't think there was any CGPA cutoff, but just to be on the safer side, 7.5 plus would be.
Any other questions?